If you've been using OBS Studio to stream and a Stream Deck to control your stream, you've probably been pretty disappointed with the lack of things that you could control. Well, today that changes because a brand new update has come out for the Stream Deck software that adds 10 highly requested new things that you can control in OBS Studio using your Stream Deck. So let's check it out. So before we update to the latest version of the Stream Deck software, you can see that there's only 5 different actions that we can do in OBS using the Stream Deck. Changing scenes, muting and unmuting mixer audio, starting and stopping a stream or a recording, and enabling and disabling a specific source. Not a whole lot of control, but once you've checked for updates and updated your Stream Deck software, you should now see the 10 new actions. So let's go through these from top to bottom. Record pause allows you to pause or resume an active recording, which is useful for those with either limited hard drive space or those that don't want to sit through hours and hours of recordings when editing. You can just press this button on your Stream Deck to resume a recording whenever you like. Personally, I'd recommend adding some custom icons for the enabled and disabled states here. The default ones that they've included just don't seem to be that intuitive for me. Next, we have a pair of actions, replay buffer and replay buffer save. The replay buffer action allows you to turn on or off the replay buffer in OBS, although it's worth noting that you need to have enabled first the replay buffer in OBS, which you can do by going to Settings, Output, Replay Buffer, and once enabled, you can customize the maximum replay time or memory used. The second action, replay buffer save, allows you to save the replay buffer to a video file on your Mac or PC. So if you had your replay buffer set to, say, 20 seconds, pressing this button on your Stream Deck will then save the last 20 seconds of your stream output to a video file, which is really useful for making full quality highlights. Also, if you want to make a really advanced instant action replay where you can actually watch back a previous highlight on stream with your viewers, then you'll want to check out my video. I'll leave it linked in the top corners, but this new update to the Stream Deck should make it even easier. The new scene collection action allows you to switch to a specific scene collection. I don't think this is that useful, obviously, when you're live, but it could be really handy if you run many different kinds of productions using OBS Studio. I would love if they also released an action to switch to a specific profile as well as the scene collections, because quite often I'm pairing up a profile with a scene collection if I want to do a local recording versus doing some kind of stream to YouTube or stream to Twitch. The media source control action allows you to have some play pause control over any specific media source in OBS. You can see the options here to have the button act as a play pause, a play stop, a play restart, or just a stop control. Another pairing of actions that are useful together are the studio mode and preview to program actions. The studio mode action just simply turns studio mode on or off, and if you've not used studio mode before, basically it just gives you 2 separate windows in OBS. The program on the right is the window that you're used to seeing, which is actually what is being sent to your stream, and the preview on the left allows you to make specific changes to any scene without it being shown to your stream. The new preview to program action, as you might have guessed, sends the preview to the program. So whatever is in your preview window is sent now live to your stream as shown in the program window. The filter action allows you to turn on or off any filter in OBS Studio, and this works for both video filters like LUTs, chroma keys, color correction, or scaling ratios, as well as audio filters that you might use on your microphone like compressors, noise gates, or equalizers via VST. This is one of those things that people have been asking to be able to control for years, so I'm sure some of you are very excited to be able to finally control filters from your Stream Deck. The screenshot action simply just takes a screenshot of the current preview in OBS, and this gets saved as a PNG to the same location as your video recordings, which you can always access by going to File and Show Recordings. Finally, the transition action allows you to switch the transition mode and allows you to set a custom duration if you wish to. Do note though that this is just updating your default scene transitions here, so if you wanted to use a stinger, you'll have to have that added in your OBS scene transitions window first. If you want to dive straight into another video, why not check out the earlier mentioned instant replay video that I did that helps you build an instant replay source that you can watch back highlights directly on stream with your audience. Thanks for watching, and I'll catch you in the next one. Peace!